It's day four of our 5-day sleigh and we have a full moon. So I thought let's get started with some yoga and we will do a moon flow and take some variations with our salutations. Let's get started. Get our arms overhead, drawing the abdomen, drawing towards back body, checking in that those ribs aren't flaring out, we're drawing the ribs down towards back and coming over side body. Just gently warming up through the body here. Coming back up to center, change the gripping in your hands. Reach up over to the other side. Lengthening through. Let's come back to center, place the hands on the top of the glutes. As you inhale, bring the gaze up, just gently up towards the ceiling. We're going to fold forward here, hinging in front of the waist, the hips, excuse me. Holding that forward fold, just bending through your left and right knee. Just warming up here. Shifting that energy from the night before. A full moon is a really great time for us to let go, release any story we tell ourselves, anything that's no longer serving us. Allow yourself to just let it. Release, set new intentions, allowing yourself, giving yourself space to invite new experiences into the next cycle. Rolling through the spine, coming back up to stand, head is last to connect. Pujala, step out to the side, inhale, draw arms up. Warming up through the knees. Good job. Taking my right foot, pointing it, taking my left foot at a 45 degree angle. We're going to reach, coming out as far as we can, creating space through side body. And then once you've created that space, only move the arms. The intention is not to crush that space and come down to the ground. We want to maintain that length through the side and move the arms soften through the neck and look up toward the ceiling. Releasing through shoulders, lengthening through the crown. Drawing abdomen toward the back body. Feel that energy radiating through the fingertips. Keep that connection here, but lowering that top palm. Framing that front shin, inhale, lift, and exhale, fold forward. Checking that that hip is drawn towards the back, so they're coming into alignment. Little adjustment here, inhale, lift, exhale, fold forward. One more. Good job, softening through that knee. Climbing up into warrior one. Adjusting your warrior if you need. Reversing. Send that back palm towards the front. Feel that heat through abdomen. Coming back into warrior two. Let's straighten through that front right leg. Keep turning that feet towards the front of the room and towards the TV. Pointing at a 45 degree angle, now that back foot, that left foot is now pointed forward. We're going to do the same on the other side. We're going to do the same on the other side. Reaching forward, creating that space through side body. And then just move the arms, gazing up toward the ceiling. Soft through the jaw and neck. Let's take that top arm all the way down, framing that shin, lowering that hip. Inhale, lift the heart, the head, exhale, fold forward. Feeling a little tight in the legs this morning, so I'm noticing that I don't have as much range as I normally would. And that's fine, I'm just staying within my body's limits today, and you should do the same. Staying within your range. Good job, softening through that front knee. Now inhale, coming up, warrior one. Let's open warrior two, then we're going to reverse our warrior. Send that back palm towards the front of the room. Good job coming back. Straighten through that front that leg, bringing both toes towards the front of the room. Bring the heels in slightly, so we're at a 45 degree angle, sinking down, coming into our goddess pose. Bending 90 degrees through the elbows, rolling index finger and thumbs. Good, checking in that pelvis is not anteriorly rotated, posteriorly rotated, excuse me. I want to drive the tailbone down, so straight through the back body, and we're engaged through core. Good. Let's extend our arms out, take that left arm underneath, bend through the elbows, back of the palms to touch. As you inhale, driving that underarm up and drawing down. Sides, right and left. Good job. And release, coming back up to stand. We're going to come back down into our squat. We're going to lift the heels up. So this is where it gets a little tricky on your balance. So lift the heels, extend down. Good. Let's place hands in full heart space, checking in it. Tailbone is drawing down and lengthening through back body. One more here. Good job. Gently take the heels down, release. Shift through the hips if you need. We're going to take our feet a little bit wider, place hands on hips, hinging forward here, fold forward. Placing that palm on the mat. Or in a block if you have one. Extend the palm up towards ceiling. Good job. Take that top palm down. Extend the other arm up. Down, folding forward. Shifting that weight forward and back. Just play around with your weight distribution here. Let's bring our feet back together. Just going to turn my body around, so bring yourself into a forward fold. Place the hands on the shins, bend through the knees, we're taking arms up, coming into chair. So checking the left elbow is tucked, arms up overhead. Holding your chair. Hands to full heart space, lift up, lengthen through upper thoracic, exhale, folding forward. Hands on shins, lift up and lengthen. Exhale, step back with right foot, step back with left. Finding downward facing dog. Looking towards the front of the mat. Let's walk, step or jump. Bring ourselves back into forward fold. Rolling back up, finding the chair. Just slight variation here. Inhale, lift up, hands to full heart space. Exhale, falling forward. Hands on shins, lift and lengthen through prayer. Exhale, fall forward, stepping back with the left, then with the right, finding downward facing dog. Looking towards the front of the mat, walk, step or jump. Inhale, lift, finding chair. holding onto the baby toe edge of that right foot and opening up through that hip space here. So sinking down. Good job. Back into your lunge. Step back into plank. Looking at the front of the mat, walk, step or jump, either or, in, find your chair, come to stand, hands with your heart space. Exhale, fall forward, hands on shins, lift them like you're this time, taking that left foot back, coming onto the edge of that foot, opening up, through the hip. So using that hand to drive away. Good job. Planting that foot, finding your lunge, back into plank, downward facing dog. Good job. Looking towards the front of the mat, walk, step or jump. And inhale, coming to chair, come to stand, hands before heart. Let's come back down to that one more time. Exhale, fold forward. Hands on the shins. Place both palms on the mat. We're going to bend through the knees and jump back into plank. Holding your plank, nice high plank. Engagement through abdomen. Taking a variation on a chaturanga here. Let's shift that weight forward so we're building and developing that shoulder strength. Elbows go towards back body. Hover for just a moment. Engage your abdomen and then lower yourself down. Back. Taking the arms off of the mat, lift the chest. Good. One more here. Inhale. Maintain that height here, strengthening. Strengthening through the back. Let's extend the arms forward and back. Two more here. Good, place the palms on the mat. Lift the knees up with the mat, engage through the thighs and hips. We're going to press our hands down into the mat to bring ourselves back up. And if you have the strength, I don't have the strength. All right, try again. If you have the strength, push up. Yes. I'm down, crazy dog. Catch it. Let's bring our elbows down towards the mat. Shift that shoulder over the elbows so that we're strengthening through shoulder space and we're just taking a step forward. So we're here, step forward. The head is just gently brushing the top of the mat. Let's lower our knees, sink the tailbone down, extend the palms forward, resting. Place the hands on the top of the shoulders or back of the neck. Good job. Extend palms forward. Finding left side body. And moving over to the other side. Coming back to center, bring yourself up into tabletop. In tabletop, we're just going to take the hips down, I'll just scooch forward. Take the hips over one side, sinking over to the other. So just stretching through that hip space. And we're gonna change our direction at the top. Back to a seated position. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I hope you're enjoying our 5-day sleigh. We've got day 5 tomorrow. We which will be fun. Studio is reopening February 3rd. I'd love to have you back in for some grounding yoga, some gentle yoga, and then on the Fridays we have bar. Thanks for spending your time with me and have a great day.